In this video, I'm going to be going over how to start a WordPress.org blog with HostGator step by step from start to finish. I'll also be providing you with an exclusive HostGator promo code that HostGator has provided me with so you can save some money on your HostGator domain name and web hosting purchase. You'll get up to 65% off HostGator hosting plus a free domain name for annual plans or a domain discount for non-annual plans. Let's get started with a HostGator WordPress.org blog tutorial. The first thing you want to do to start a WordPress.org blog with HostGator is to click the link in the description below so you'll be taken to HostGator, and so you can take advantage of the HostGator discount by getting up to 65% off. I've included the promo code to enter at checkout with the link. The promo code is Cupid60. A little disclosure, the link is an affiliate link, meaning I receive a commission from HostGator at no extra cost to you. Plus, you'll get an awesome HostGator discount. Once you click the link in the description below, you'll be on the HostGator homepage. Click the Get Started button. You'll now be on the HostGator Plans page. You'll see three different plans you can choose from: the Hatchling, Baby, and Business Plan. You'll see the discounted amount that is being shown for the plans. You'll be able to save even more than what is showing with our exclusive HostGator promo code. The Hatchling plan is a great plan if you're going to have one site or just starting out. The Hatchling plan allows you for you to have one website. If you're going to have multiple sites, the Baby plan is a good plan as it allows unlimited websites. The difference in the Hatchling and Baby plan is the Baby plan comes with unlimited websites, and the Hatchling plan, you're limited to one site. The Business plan comes with unlimited sites like the Baby plan. It includes more features like a free upgrade to a positive SSL, free dedicated IP, and the HostGator add-on SEO tools. Click the Buy Now button on the plan you want to select. For this tutorial, I'm going to select the Hatchling plan. You'll now be on the Choose a Domain section. You'll see you'll get a free domain name for annual plans. If you go with the non-annual plan, you'll get a domain discount by using our exclusive promo code at checkout. You can type in a domain name that you like for your site. If you click the .com over to the right, you can choose the domain extension you want for your domain name. If you already own a domain name, you can click the I already own this domain tab at the top and type in the domain you own. After you choose your domain, scroll down and you'll see the domain privacy protection that is selected if you chose a domain name. You can select or unselect domain privacy. Completely up to you. I do recommend domain privacy as it'll keep your personal information private so that spammers and telemarketers won't have access to your personal information and contact you by phone, an email with offers of their services. When you register a domain name, no matter what company you choose, the domain goes into the public Whois directory as domain names are regulated. If you select domain privacy, it'll show HostGator's default contact information instead of yours. Highly recommend domain privacy plus protection. Next, scroll down to the Choose a Hosting Plan section. You'll see under billing cycle, 36 months. If you click this, you'll see the pricing without the promo code. Let's now add in our exclusive HostGator promo code. Scroll down to the Enter a Coupon Code section. Replace the promo code that is there with Cupid60. Scroll back up to the Billing Cycle section. You'll now see the new discounted rate showing. You can choose to pay monthly, every 6 months, 12 months, or 36 months. Once you choose a hosting term to go with, scroll down to the Create Your HostGator Account section. Enter an email address and password. Next, scroll down to the Enter Billing Info section. Input your billing information. You can also choose to pay with PayPal if you wish. Next, scroll down to the Add Additional Services section. This is where you can select any HostGator add-on services that you want. All these add-ons are completely optional. You'll see the SSL certificate add-on. HostGator does come with a free SSL certificate for your site, so this add-on isn't necessary unless you want to upgrade to a positive SSL certificate, which will allow you to show a site security badge on your site if you'd like. And with the positive SSL certificate, you'll have a $10,000 limited guarantee warranty by Komodo. Next, you will see SiteLock Essentials. This add-on checks your website daily for malware and protects your site from hackers and malicious attacks. It will notify you if your site has been hacked into and malicious code has been placed into it. SiteLock Essentials also removes malware automatically. This add-on can be beneficial and give you peace of mind if your site were to get hacked into and malware is placed on it. If you're going to be using WordPress for your site, there are free security plugins that do a good job at security as well. The next add-on is professional email. This add-on provides you with an email address ending your domain name, along with other features provided by Google Workspace such as Gmail, Calendar, Chat, Cloud Storage with Drive, Video Conferencing with Meet, and many more Google Workspace features. I do want to note that HostGator does come with free email addresses ending in your domain name, so this add-on isn't necessary unless you really want to utilize all of the added features with Google Workspace. The next add-on is Site Backup. This will back up your site daily, and you can restore your site to a previous backup with a click of a button with their one-click restore. This add-on can be a good one because if your site gets hacked into, or you mess something up while creating it, or editing it, you can restore it to the version right before whatever happened took place and everything will be back to normal. This add-on can be very beneficial as you never know when you might need it. The next add-on is HostGator SEO Tools. HostGator SEO Tools will provide you with reports, insights, and analytics regarding the SEO for your site. And it'll recommend things to do to improve the SEO of your site. It will also report your site to search engines. This add-on isn't really necessary. It touches the basics in terms of SEO and is limited in what it tracks. It could be helpful for some if you aren't familiar with SEO at all. Next, you'll be at the Enter a Coupon Code section. If you haven't already, replace the promo code that is there with Cupid60 to take advantage of our exclusive HostGator discount. Now just scroll down and accept the terms and conditions and click the Checkout Now button. You will now be directed to a thank you page. HostGator will now email you your HostGator receipt and your HostGator billing and cPanel login credentials so you can begin creating your site. HostGator will now automatically take you to the HostGator dashboard. We now want to install WordPress. You can do this a few ways. You can click the Install WordPress link. It'll take you to the Install WordPress page. You can also get to the WordPress install page by clicking the Launch cPanel button, which will take you to the HostGator cPanel. If you log into your HostGator cPanel, you'll be here on the main cPanel page. Scroll all the way down to the bottom to the Soft Aculus Apps Installer. Click on WordPress. Click the Install Now button. Where you see the Choose a Protocol, keep this selected as HTTP. When you first sign up with HostGator, it can take a little bit of time for the secure key to be activated, usually up to 24 hours. By keeping this to HTTP, you can get started installing WordPress now and get started with your site without experiencing any errors. After the 24-hour period, you can activate the SSL certificate with a few clicks in the HostGator cPanel once the secure key is ready. Next, choose a domain that you want to have for the WordPress installation. Next, put in the site name, site description. Over to the right, put in the admin username, which will be the username for logging into WordPress. Put in a password and put in an email address. Scroll down and you can change the language for WordPress if you'd like. If you want anything over on the right, you can select it. I'm not going to select anything. You don't need to select any of it unless you want it. Next, scroll down to the select a theme. You can choose a WordPress theme for your site here. I recommend choosing one in the WordPress dashboard. If you happen to see one here, feel free to select it. Click the Install button. WordPress is now being installed. It'll take just a few minutes. Once it is done installing, you will see, "Congratulations, the software was installed successfully." Click the administrative URL to go to the WordPress dashboard. This is the WordPress dashboard. Something to note, I would bookmark the administrative URL, as this is the easiest way to log into WordPress to begin in creating your site. To log into WordPress, just enter your domain name with a /wp-admin, just like you see here. This will take you to the WordPress login page for your site. Once logged in, you'll be in the WordPress dashboard. Let's get to know WordPress a bit. Now we want to pick out a theme to begin creating a site. To pick out a theme for your site, on the far left, you will see tabs. Find the Appearance tab and hover over it. Click Themes, as this is where you can pick out a theme for your site. Next, click WordPress.org themes at the top. You'll now see featured WordPress themes. If you click popular, it'll showcase popular WordPress themes you can choose from. If you click latest, it'll show you the latest WordPress themes you can choose from. There are thousands of themes that you can choose from. Once you find a theme, hover over it and click the install button. Once it is done installing, click the activate button. This is now the WordPress theme for your site. If you want to browse premium WordPress themes, you can click the Premium button and you can browse premium themes from the HostGator Marketplace. If you click Demo, you can view what the theme looks like. You can also get to these premium themes by hovering over HostGator in the left menu, then click Marketplace. Let's continue in getting to know WordPress. On the far left, you will see Post. Post is where you can add new posts. Pages is where you can add new pages. The Media tab is where you can upload images to your site or where your images will show that you have already uploaded to your site. Comments is where you can view comments people leave on your blog. Hover over the Plugins tab in the left menu, click Add New. This is where you can add new plugins for your site. Pretty much any feature or customization you would want, more than likely there's a plugin to do that. One of the best plugins that can make starting your WordPress site on HostGator easier is a plugin called Elementor. Elementor Page Builder is a drag and drop editor for WordPress. Elementor is the number one WordPress page builder, and over 8 million websites have been built with Elementor. This plugin can save you a ton of time and lots of headaches figuring out how to make specific customizations. This plugin has a free version and a paid version. I provide a link in the description below to check out Elementor. If you want to activate this plugin for your WordPress site, find the Plugins tab over to the left and click Add New. Type in Elementor in the search field. You'll see the Elementor plugin. Click the Install Now button and click Activate to activate the plugin. Another great site if you need help with designing your customizations in WordPress is Fiverr. Fiverr is a great place to get tasks done at a cheap and competitive price. It is helpful if you need a logo, website changes, or something else done. I provide the link in the description below. That is my HostGatorWordPress.org blog tutorial on how to start a WordPress.org blog with HostGator. Give this video a thumbs up and leave us a comment letting us know if the tutorial was helpful or not, as the comments help improve our tutorials. Be sure to subscribe to our channel for more HostGator web hosting tutorial videos.